Professor Pathak, what I feel that we should start.
Yeah, I think so. Okay.
As and when the people will
Okay.
join, they will connect and we
Yeah,
make
yeah.
adjustment
Okay.
accordingly.
Okay. Okay.
But one person, you keep in constant touch with that, those who are going to speak, when they
Yeah.
are, what is the convenient time that they should connect accordingly.
Okay. Good morning to Sri OP Gupta ji, Chief Controller General, Patent Designs and Trademarks. I welcome Sri Hardeo Karar ji to our webinar, Joint Controller, Delhi office. I welcome Professor M.N. Patel sir to our, who is our Provost sir. So I am very happy to welcome all present to attend this inaugural session of 3-day webinar, which is from 7 to 9th October 2020, and want to inform that on my request application, GUSCO's Government of Gujarat sanctioned rupees 25,000 to Parul University to conduct this 3-day webinar covering all aspects of IPRs, namely patents, patent cooperation treaty, trademarks, copyrights, geographical indications, trade secrets, design of integrated circuits, and Farmers' Right and Plant Varieties Act. I welcome all the delegates, all invited speakers, and all faculty members who have registered for it to this very important event. I welcome President Devanshu sir, President of Parul University and Managing Trustee, and Provost sir, Dr. M.N. Patel, to this webinar. I'm extremely delighted to welcome Sri O.P. Gupta ji, Senior IAS Officer and Chief Controller General of Patent Designs and Trademarks, Indian Patent Office, Mumbai, who has very kindly agreed to grace the occasion as chief guest. And I welcome Sri Hardeo Karar ji, Joint Controller from Delhi Patent Office, and Dr. Narottam Sahu ji, advisor and member secretary, GUSCO, Government of Gujarat, as guest of honor in an inaugural session. 15 lectures covering all aspects of IPRs, namely patents, patent cooperation treaty and licensing of patents, copyrights, Industrial Design Act, geographical indications, trade secrets, design of integrated circuits, farmers' rights and plant variety act, etc., are being covered in this webinar during the next 3 days, including today, by invited eminent speakers in the field of IPRs. I am sure all of you will get desired knowledge in all aspects through these deliberations. Once again, I welcome all invited speakers and delegates to this 3-day webinar on IPRs.
Thank you.
Now I request Devanshu sir, who is president of Parul University and managing trustee, to say a few words to inaugurate this webinar.
Thank
Devanshu
you,
sir.
Dr. Pathak. Thank you, everyone, for being there on this session. First of all, let me thank Gupta sir and Narottam Sahu sir for sparing their valuable time for this webinar, which is especially focused on intellectual property rights and copyrights, how it can be promoted in higher education. At Parul University, we are one of the most diverse universities in Gujarat, with almost all the faculties available in one campus. And today, the special emphasis for this webinar is on engineering. And as we all know, we are now in law. I think Parul University campus is the best place to have such an interdisciplinary work, especially for engineering students. And this year, we also got the privilege to host the hackathon of Ministry of Human Resource and Development, where there were a lot of interdisciplinary problems involved, in the hackathon competition for the students to solve. There were problems related to pharma, there was problems related to medicine, there were problems related to agriculture, and our engineering students could very well tie up with students of this discipline to come up with good solutions to this particular problem statements which were posed by the Ministry of HRD. So I think engineering students and faculty, if they receive in-depth knowledge on intellectual property rights, the process involved in how to come up with an idea, how to come up with a problem statement, how to collaborate with industry for problem statement to make the project more relevant and to make the project more industry centric, so that whatever solution can come out of this problem can be useful for the society. So it's very important for us to train our students and teachers in this area. And after identifying a suitable problem, or I would say an appropriate problem, how to work on the solution of this problem. And once you find the solution, how to protect your intellectual work in form of patent or copyright is again very important. And I am very happy to see that in last one decade, a lot of work has happened in Gujarat. As a result, this year we could come as one of the most innovative state, or the state which promotes startups and innovation at the highest level in entire India. And I think there is a lot of contribution coming from all the institutions of Gujarat. So there is a lot of awareness now. But still, if we compare the national scenario with international scenario, we are far behind. And we see countries like Switzerland, which are very small in terms of their size and population, they are ranking very high in innovation and entrepreneurship in comparison to India, despite of being very small in size and population. So it talks about their innovation culture, basically how they work on promotion of innovation and the promotion of how to safeguard intellectual property rights. So I think if we do it in proper way, we can bring about lot many changes, and we can increase the ranking of the India year after year, which is definitely improving in last one decade. But given the young population we have, given the higher education scenario we have in India, there is a huge potential for us to grow in this area. And once we grow in this area, if we change our processes, it is definitely going to impact the outcome, the industrial produce, the impact on the economy, and ultimate well-being of Indian society and the nation at large. So I think this is a very apt selection of the topic. And with support of highest officials like Guptaji and Narottam Sahuji, I think there will be a lot of seriousness from all the stakeholders. And whatever we could take out of this seminar, I think it will definitely impact the processes at Parul University on all the participants outside Parul University who are going to attend it. And this has given impact already in institutions like us, very young institution. We are only 5-year-old university, and we are privileged to have our university ranked in top 50 universities on Atal ranking for innovation. So this is a great achievement, I can say. And this was only possible because of the organizational support we received from the government and the kind of inputs we received from people like Gupta sir and Narottam Sahuji, and from education minister, the education secretary. And that's how we could grow. And this kind of processes will help us keep doing good things in this area. And I'm very happy to tell all of you that we have a dedicated resource in our research and development cell, where there are 4 to 5 senior professors working in different areas in promotion of innovation. And we have an entrepreneurship cell. We have a team of 10 people exclusively working on startup and innovation. They're not involved in teaching process, but they're prime responsibility is to identify students who are having deep inclination for innovation and research. So in and all, I think this kind of initiatives will definitely help us to boost this culture of innovation in our university. I again thank all the stakeholders for their kind presence, and I wish my best of luck to all of you for the success of this webinar. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir, for your kind words. Now, I request Professor Dr. M. N. Patel, sir, Honorable Provost, Parul University, to address the audience which is online and tell something about uniqueness of Parul University besides whatever he wants to say. Thank you, sir.
Good morning to one and all. I hope so that I am audible to all. It's really a pleasure for me and happy feel that a 3 days workshop, 7, 8 and 9 October on IPR is planned with the support of Gujcos by CR4D, and especially on that occasional occasion of the inaugural function, I have privileged to welcome a special guest on that, Mr. O.P. Guptaji, Mr. Kararji and my friend Narottam Shahuji, as he is always be a well-wisher of me, especially individual and then for Parul University. So really, I welcome all these resource person, guests, CRD4 team, participant for such an event, which obviously be a need of a day. And hope so that at the deliberation of three days, we are going to have something which can be add to our rather a new feathers in our cap. So fastest growing university in Western India, that Parul University, everyone know. And as we see that we are adding more and more things in that. So we have seen the standard you might have going to see the standard documentary film where what Parul University is, and little bit it is said by our president that it is a big campus, green campus, clean campus, and whatever word you can use, but it can only be possible when you physically visit the campus, then you feel the vibrancy of overall rather in the campus. And for the overall development is motto of our university. And for that, university has created more than 20 cell. Out of that, one of the cell that Professor Devansu, Dr. Devansu has mentioned about that EDC. Similarly, we have more than 20 cells so that we can take care of overall development of our student, where 100 officers dedicatedly work in that area. So that we can give best to our student and to justify our slogan, be here, be vibrant. This is about the Parul University. But I have to add now to this that when we have started as a group of Parul colleges, I was associate with the GTU, and I will put on record some of the things. When Parul group of colleges affiliated to GTU, on the page of a pattern of GTU, more than 100 pattern was appeared by the Parul Institute of Technology and makes the best award of more, the highest number of the pattern, which was a day when there was a great contribution of our Mr. Professor Javiers, who had dedicated strengthen our IPR cell in such a way by arranging so many lectures every year. But unfortunately, due to his ill sick health, his contribution became little weak and he is not now connected with us. And our new team of CRD4 is going to take care of our pattern for to strengthen that. And I hope so that they will pick up the good speed and having a big new will bring a good food in the area of coming years, especially in the patents. As an individual, I'm very much thankful to Gujcos for extending a support of a supercomputer to PIT this year. Last year, they have given to 10 good institutions and universities, state universities. This year, they have given to 10 more. And being a policy of government, they are going to give more and more support to all other universities. So the supercomputer is a need of a day where our engineering students are going to work aggressively on the artificial intelligence, machine learning, data structure, and so many new area of computer. 2 years back also, I put on record that our Gujcos has sanctioned more than 60 proposals in the various area where we have refreshed our courses, we have strengthened our knowledge with the sizable grant of the Gujcos. So we are always thankful to Gujcos because their support constantly since number of years, the Parul group of colleges and now Parul University is receiving. As I also to mention that the new initiative of government SSIP, that is a student startup and innovation policy, I also take some liberty to say about that. It was my brainchild when I was Vice Chancellor of Gujarat University. The policy was framed by me. It was inaugurated by our Honorable Chief Minister in January 17. And now it is replicated not only in the Gujarat, but the country as a whole, where also we are getting a very sizable amount. And our young, the budding entrepreneurs are working on that. And especially I can say that in SOSE and so many activity under that startup and that innovation we are doing, it is a unique and considerable that government has also noticed that the Parul University is working very well in this area. Before the university saver status, many colleges of Parul campus also got the proposal of R&D TapTech, Modra from AICT. Recently, we are recognized by Schedule 1 Auditor by Environment Department of GPCB, where also I am member there in R&D team. I am member in that technical committee team. I am also member that in EC, that is Environment Clearance team, where we have about more than industry allotted this year to you. And they are the big industry like Reliance. And one of the industries recently where there was a big accident, that is SSC. And we are supposed to audit for that. And we are also applying for the second team of environment and going to create the environment lab by next March. We have another team under the leadership of Professor Bulekar, who has recently completed 2 days international conference on awareness of environment, which have got a very good success. So as so far vibrancy is concerned, our CID for sale is now very aggressively working, and hope so that a lot of good fruits will come with the support of government, with support of the government officer, as we are receiving since number of years, and in future also we are going to get that support. So my best wishes to this workshop of 3 days, where a lot of deliberation will take place, and our new participant and our teachers will learn a lot from that and create their mindset so that they can think for the pattern and so on. So again, best wishes to CRD4 team, and my best wishes to all the participants, those who are going to learn by 3 days of this workshop. Thank you very much. Over to Professor Pathak.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your enlightening words and encouraging words to CR4D and to all of us. Thank you indeed, sir. Now, I welcome wholeheartedly Honorable Sri O.P. Gupta ji, the Chief Controller General of Patent Designs and Trademarks, who has very kindly accepted our invitation. I really appreciate his humbleness, and I must acknowledge the support and help given by his secretary, Madam Pereira, who was always willing to help us and connect to O.P. Gupta Ji for this noble cause of this webinar. So, O.P. Gupta sir, he will give as chief guest the inaugural address in this webinar, and his introduction. He is a very known personality, being a very senior IAS officer, but still for the benefit of audience, I have to give his brief experience. Sri O.P. Gupta ji took over as Controller General of Patent Design and Trademarks in the Office of Controller General of Patents, Designs and Trademarks, India on 16 November 2015. So almost 5 years he has been working there. Prior to this assignment, Sri O.P. Gupta ji was working as Chairman and Managing Director of Maharashtra Electricity Distribution Company Limited. Sri Gupta ji is B.E. in Mechanical Engineering, and he belongs to Engineering Fraternity. That's why I am very happy to invite him as chief guest to this occasion. And an Indian Administrative Service Officer of 1992 batch, which is 30 years of service he has put. He has served as an Inspector General of Registration and Controller of Stamps, Maharashtra, General Manager, West Mumbai, Vice Chairman and Managing Director of MSRTC, Maharashtra, Collector of Amravati and Satara districts in the state of Maharashtra, and Chief Executive Officer of Akola Jila Parishad during his 27 years of administrative service. Sri O.P. Gupta ji will talk on importance of intellectual property rights in universities and corporate world for advancement of our country. Thank you. So may I invite Gupta ji sir to give inaugural address as chief guest.
Thank you, Professor Pathak.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for inviting me as chief guest for this 3-day webinar. Dr. Devansh Patel, President and Managing Trustee of Parul University. Dr. M.N. Patel, Provost of Parul University. Professor Pathak, Mr. Sahau, my colleague, Dr. Karar, and all esteemed faculty and students of Parul University and other participants in this 3-day webinar. First of all, I thank you, Dr. Professor Pathak, for my introduction and kind words which he has talked about me. Yes, I have been now in this office close to 5 years, And it has been a wonderful experience, which part of it I would like to share with the audience today. I should compliment Parul University for this webinar organization, because when we talk about intellectual property, very few people actually know as to what is intellectual property. Because most of us, when we grow up, we always know about movable property and immovable property, but very few of us know and understand what is intellectual property. In fact, if I talk about my own experience, the first time ever I heard the word intellectual property was probably when I was studying in IIT Delhi and preparing for certain exams, when we heard the word TRIPS, because those days TRIPS agreement was under negotiation. And at that time we heard something that, you know, trade related to intellectual property rights. And that's what we first time heard as intellectual property. But otherwise, I'm sure most of us do hear these words individually as patent or trademark in a very generic sense. Something like we people must have heard about that this particular, you know, in crickets and various other fields, we hear commentators talking on the screen saying that this is a trademark shot of a particular batsman. Like, I still remember when I was a young kid, we used to hear that square cut is a trademark shot of Vishwanath, Mundappa Vishwanath. Now we know that Mahendra Singh Dhoni had a trademark shot called helicopter shot. Now we hear these words and somebody say that this is his patented style. So we hear these words patent and trademark without actually knowing or understanding the meaning of the word itself. And that's where you know, this kind of webinar becomes so important when at this young age, when the students are there in the university, if they understand these things, these terms, and what importance they have, not only in the economic development of a company or an individual, but of economic development of a country as a whole, then we realize that how important this word intellectual property is. And intellectual property rights, you know, they have been in the public domain for close to 300 plus years now. When we trace the history of intellectual property rights, it started way back in 15th and 16th century in Europe, in places like Venice and UK, then UK. But when we talk about formalization of the Patent Act, I think US patent law is the one of the earliest one of 1790. And then how important it is, this point they understood way back in those years, when they said that for people to invent something, to do some, you know, make effort and find technical solution to problems and be novel in that particular field, they need to be given certain rights in this regard. And that's how the concept of intellectual property rights, that people who invent, people who comes up with a novel idea, people who convert that novel idea through an inventive step into a product or a process, then they get the patent. The terms have been differentiating, you know, differing in different countries prior to the modern IP regime, which has come in place after the TRIPS agreement. And then India also joined the TRIPS agreement at the beginning in 1995. And then of course, we got 10 years grace period and became full member in terms of the whole IP regime of the world from 1st January 2005. So when we talk about importance of intellectual property in terms of, you know, first few inventions which I could trace, they actually comes in places like Venice and in Europe, where those days cooks, if they invented some recipe which is really, really good, actually they used to get monopoly rights on that recipe itself, so that people shall not copy, and cooks get incentive to try and experiment and come up with more and more such inventions. The formal engineering invention, if we see, look back, it probably goes back some kind of a water pump where the technology was to draw water from the ground and then pass it on to the fields for agriculture and for other purposes. And that invention was given up monopoly rights. Those days, the word patent was still probably not in place. So that's how this whole thing came up in terms of patents. Copyright, of course, have been in place even little earlier in country like UK, where different kind of advantages or rights were given to people who were coming up with creative work in terms of art, culture, and music, and other these things. But when we talk about the modern IP systems, even though India had a Patent and Design Act of 1911, prior to that, under British India, India became part of the international IP regime at that point of time when we were part of the British India. The 1911 Act continued till 1970, when independent India, the Parliament of modern India, enacted the Indian Patent Act in 1970. Similarly, the Trademark Act, which was there earlier in 1940, was replaced by 1958 Trade and Mercantile Act. And these two things continued to carry forward our IP regime till we became members of the TRIPS agreement. Of course, Copyright Act was also there in place in 1957. After becoming full member of the TRIPS agreement, India became obliged to align its laws in line with the rest of the world and as per the TRIPS agreements. The uniform terms of patent for 20 years, patent grant in both product and processes, and no distinctive treatment to the nationals of any India itself or any other country, as uniform treatment to all nationals across the world are to be given under TRIPS agreement. So these were the major things which India agreed to as part of the TRIPS agreement. Yeah. Similar things became applicable in trademarks and copyright and design. And therefore, we really revamped our laws totally. So Indian Patent Act 1970 was amended three times, 1998, 2002 and 2005, to align it with the Indian obligations under TRIPS agreement. Similarly, we redid our trademark law and we came up absolutely new law on Trademark Act in 1999. We separated the Design Act as a Design Act 2000 separate act. Similar acts we came up in geographical indications and the Semiconductor Layout Design Act. And Copyright Act also was amended to align with the TRIPS agreement. So all this process was done between 1995 and 2005, when India joined the TRIPS and got the 10 years grace period to align its laws to reach that level. In 2005, we became fully compliant with our obligations under TRIPS agreement. And our conditions, in that sense, even though you'll probably hear it during these lectures, which I see they are there, that some countries still say that Indian laws are restrictive or create some hindrances to foreign applicants in certain technology fields. But let me assure you very clearly that we are fully compliant under TRIPS agreement. And anybody talking about Indian laws not being in fully compliant, whether it's Section 3D in pharmaceuticals, whether it is provisions regarding compulsory licenses or other such provisions, those provisions have been debated, discussed, and argued at all forums in the world, including the Indian Supreme Court. And there are clear case laws, there are clear discussion papers, and it's absolutely clear that those laws are fully in compliance of India's obligations under the TRIPS agreement. So whosoever, wherever, in whatever forum when people do talk about Indian laws not being in full conformity in certain field, as I say, pharmaceuticals or compulsory license, please, you as students, you as faculty, because you have this thing where you will interact in this regard with lots of people as we go forward in life. Please, you have no reason to be defensive about it. You can simply say that Indian state is a state which gives monopoly rights in intellectual property, but does not let the social aspect and the society benefits be left behind for private benefits. So Indian law balances private benefits with the social benefits. And that's where Indian law is now being treated as one of the model laws for developing countries and underdeveloped countries. In fact, when international level, there are lots of NGOs and lots of international organizations like South Center, they actually give example of Indian law as the one law in patents, which provides the real balanced playground for industry as well as the society. Because when I'm coming to speak on benefits of IPR to the institutional and corporate, I need to just give this brief background, as at times the corporates may feel that they are not getting full value of their efforts and their inventions, in terms of returns on their investment. But let me assure you that Indian law gives full liberty, full support to all inventions, and make sure that the inventors do get their rightful return while undertaking such intellectual property related activity. Now, when we talk about the interaction between academia and corporate, this is a real important aspect where the IP regime is so important. Because where India has lost out during last few years, and why we have not been able to reach those levels of development which lots of other countries have already reached. One of the drawbacks at that point of time was considered is that India's patent regime was really restrictive, to that sense that we used to give patents only to the products or processes, not to products. And that was till 2005. And that put restrictions in terms of investment, which people would, because they were not sure that whatever product they launch, that product will get copied, and that process, since India gave only process patents, people may end up copying that process through reverse engineering or whatever means, and they may lose out on the investment. And that was one drawback which we had prior to 2005, which we have corrected. Second was, there was no specific policy as to how we will treat intellectual property in the country. National IPR policy was brought in 2016 as to that effect, because that policy gives future directional guidelines and commitment of the government to the world at large.
Continue, Karun.
And India, I'm audible. Professor Patel, I'm audible.
Yeah. Kindly go ahead.
So the national IPR policy very clearly laid down the objectives of India's intellectual property regime and the policy for future. Now, these things, they provide a real base where now the Indian industry and Indian academic institutions, because as we see in India, most of the research activity is still undertaking in educational institutions, or when we talk about laboratories, they are mostly public funded laboratories. Of course, recently, when I see last 5 years, lots of private universities now have come up with very good research and development centers. Parul University is one such example which has been brought out. Somebody talked about MIT University prior to this. And when I see numbers now, patent filing and the patent grants, a lot of other universities which are run by, you know, not by the government management, and they are probably privately managed universities, they are now coming up in big way in their research and development centers. But when we talk about the research and development taking place in academic institutions, it shall not only be to the extent of publishing papers or even acquiring patent rights. Because when we see the commercialization aspect, it was just around 3% in 2016-17. So that is where, when we talking about the return on investment, if people are putting money, they're undertaking various research and development activities, but if the product or the process is not commercialized, then obviously the returns on investment are not received. And then future money to invest is not there. And that's where the interaction with industry becomes very important. The corporate, in fact, when we see, I'll give you a simple example regarding US. In US, till around 1980s, when the development in pharmaceutical field, there were lots of patents which used to be granted. And those patents were for the universities, which were mostly public funded at that point of time. The commercialization of those patents was very, very low. And then at that point of time, this one of the most famous acts, which is called Bayh-Dole Act in US, was brought in. And that Bayh-Dole Act allowed interaction of the corporate and academic institutions by way of licensing or, you know, transfer of patent rights from the academia to the corporate. And that created such an ecosystem which resulted in US becoming number one in pharmaceutical developments immediately thereafter. The number of patents which used to be granted, they not only increased, but the commercialization and the new drug discoveries, they increased by leaps and bounds. And as we see today, the pharmaceutical industry, they really benefited out of it. But of course, when we talk about the social aspect of it, maybe that is a debatable point. Yet in US, as we have heard from debate, that whether they got the best price for all these inventions or not is still a question mark, because that's where lots of companies which did generic medicine development, they got to enter, and now they've kind of created a balance field to that extent. But those commercial aspects are certainly not part of the discussions today. But the interaction between the academia and corporate, this is the best example when we talk about, or we look at, you know, other places like German car industry, the Swiss watch industry. You know, these are the things where the invention in laboratories and in academic institutions have got transferred to the corporate, and that they've been seen as a product across the world. In India, we are still at that stage where such things, except for our IT companies, which were able to, you know, create that kind of a thing outside India, in terms of manufacturing systems and processes, we are still not at that level where we are capable of. And I'm sure with this kind of webinars, the interaction with students, faculty, and the corporate, as it goes ahead in future, more and more interaction will result in more and more inventions taking place in academic institutions, getting transferred to the corporate, and then get converted to product and processes which will be recognized in the world. Therefore, the national IPR policy, actually the first objective when we see is the awareness, you know, about IPRs. So creation of awareness about IPRs. And there, the concept of awareness through industry, in the sense, the various programs which we undertake with various industry associations, whether FICCI, CII, or ASSOCHAM, but in educational institutions, the more focus has been given in terms of awareness. And therefore, we have the government of India has already requested the state governments to undertake creation of IP cells, not only in the state, but in their universities. And I'm happy to note, in fact, in Gujarat, I have been interacting regarding Gujarat a lot more often. And I have complimented Gujarat government and the system over there, where they have a state level IP cell, and they have cells, IP cells in most of the universities. In fact, in the introduction, I was told that Parul University also has an IP cell inside the university. Now, this is a very positive aspect. So creation of IP cells in academic institutions, in universities, apart from the science and technology department or higher education department in the state. And then undertaking these awareness activities across the state, across the various stakeholders. It's students, faculty, the corporate entities, startups, investors, all of those people. And that is such an important aspect, that this awareness will then obviously create two aspects. One is, lots of people do lots of inventive work, especially in academic institutions, research work, but they end up publishing the work without realizing that that work may be having intellectual property value. And as we all know, that once you publish a work, prior to creating an IP right on that work, then the same application in later stage will get hit by what we call prior art, because your publication is in public domain. And then when we do the patent search, this published paper, if comes out, you cannot get your intellectual property right if the application was filed beyond that stipulated period, which is provided by law, which is 6 months in India. So sometimes in India, especially in academic institutions, because for professors, for researchers, the publication list in their biodata or in curriculum is very important for not only their own personal reputation, but for the future career of theirselves. So publishing paper is, of course, one aspect where our faculties and our academic community gives more precedence, without realizing that they may be losing an intellectual property right in this. So this is awareness number one, where people should see that if they have come up through a research which actually has a value in intellectual property, they should first file an application for intellectual property right and then only publish the work. So that is one important aspect. Second, when we talk about the amount and the money is required for research and development, not all universities do have that kind of financial autonomy and the money is available to them. And therefore, the concept of joint research, where industry comes up with a problem and provide the project work and the money to the academic institutions. And because when we talk about patent, the three basic components in the patent is novelty, inventive step, and the industrial application. So industrial application, if you come up with a problem, then how to solve that problem through a novel concept and through a product or process which is inventive in itself, will provide a stimulus and advantages to the academic institutions. And that's where the industry and academia, they really need to handhold together. So awareness aspect, when we talk about national IPR policy, we have been trying to connect academic institutions and industry in this regard. And third aspect is bringing it down, not only to university level, but little below, where we talk about schools and junior colleges. And therefore, the concept of Niti Aayog, of talking about Atal Tinkering Labs and those kind of things, where in a school, the students are given basics of intellectual property, a basic knowledge of intellectual property. Now, in NCERT syllabus, we have already included IP as a chapter in the class 11th and 12th syllabus, which then create these students, as a recipient to the knowledge when they join technical universities or future colleges, and then they understand the whole concept. So awareness aspect we are trying to undertake. Second is providing assistance to file an IP application, because our researchers and our academicians are very good in doing their work in the laboratory. But when we talk about filing an IP application, how to draft an application, how to draft a claim, how to put in those specifications, which make sure that the novel ideas and the inventive steps are very clearly brought out in the application. This, I'm sure, not too many professors or our researchers are still apt at. And therefore, of course, for startups, we have provided a specific program through the CG office and the Government of India scheme, what we call SIPP scheme. But in universities and such places, we have come up with this concept of Technology Innovation and Support Center, TISC, with the help of BIPO. So we have a MOU with BIPO, where BIPO is the World Intellectual Property Organization, which is the world body which administers most of the IP treaties across the world and do the rule setting for the international IP regime. So BIPO and Indian government are now setting up these technology and innovation support centers across the country. First preference to set up these TISCs is in the university campuses, because then in the TISC, the people who are there, they can handhold the academic aspect of it, and they can draft applications, they can provide patent search, they can provide the basic information whether this particular research results in a creation of IP or not. And then they can help you provide professional services, because they are being supported through our office as well as government. So they can do your handholding in filing IP applications. So one part is, creating suitable atmosphere for research and development through industry academia handholding. Second is drafting of those IP applications and filing for IP, that is through academia, industry, and this TISC, handholding. So this is the part of awareness and creation of IP, which are the two first and second objectives of national IP efforts. That's why I was saying that, this kind of things, when brought down very clearly, provides a very clear, foundation for where we can build up on our system. Of course, all these steps in last few years are showing results in terms of filing, because in India, the filings have gone up during last 3-4 years, consistently at around 10%. Of course, we try to create an ecosystem where they go much faster, because for India's population or India's academic and technological size, the number of patent filings in India is still far behind, because last year we got around 55,000 applications as compared to 1 million+ applications in China, or 500,000 applications in US, or even 400,000 applications in Europe. So this is where we are looking at to provide that kind of ecosystem where Indian patent filings also go to those levels. That is part of the national IPR policy. Then we talk about commercialization and, of course, enforcement issues. These are part of the national IPR policies, which I'm sure as part of your lecture series, others will be covering. But to stay on the main topic as to how important this IPR is for faculties and corporate world in academic institutions, as I said, is that once this kind of handholding takes place and that ecosystem gets created in that sense, that it becomes a vicious cycle, where a virtuous cycle, where the industry put in money for research and development, and the new product and processes come up, where industry is able to commercialize them, India itself is a big market. India also has lots of trade agreements where the world market is available for us. And then because of this, they get decent returns on their investment, and this, you know, the money already start flowing in the system. So that is the aspect of the real benefit of IPR. We have, in terms of processing, you know, to facilitate this, as I said, the steps which we have taken through national IPR policies. The second most important thing which we have done in last 5 years was removing delays and pendencies in offices. Because one of the other reasons as to why India was unable to get many applications is that the time taken to process those applications was too much. In fact, when I took office in 2015, we used to take around 72 months to examine a new patent application. Now that, by international standards, was really, really bad. In fact, we were second from the bottom in around 90 countries across the world. Today, that 72 months period has already brought down to less than 12 months in a lot of technology fields, except few technology fields where we are still examining little older applications. Most of the applications, we are now reaching between 12 to 16 months as on today, which by the end of this year, we plan to bring down that all new patent applications filed in India should get examined within less than 12 months. That is in terms of patent examination. Subsequent processing and finalization of patent decision should take another 12 months from that. Of course, that will take another 2 years. But in between, to make sure that genuine people do get their patent rights within time, we came up with the concept of expedited examination. And under that program, in last 2.5 years, we have already sanctioned more than 1,000 patents, more than 3,000 applications have been filed, where the total time taken from the request of examination till the final decision is less than 1 year, which is the fastest, among the fastest in the world. So we are now telling the stakeholders that you want to get a patent right quickly in India, please use the expedited route. And we have, you know, expanded the field under which people can file expedited applications. So this we have done in last 2 years. In trademarks, similarly, where normal trademark applications used to take 13 months to examination and 3 to 5 years for a registration, now we register almost all the trademarks where there is no opposition or there is prima facie no objection under law within less than 6 months. Now, this is the timelines which we have brought in. Copyright and design also, we do application examinations and decision making within 30 days. So this is another incentive which we have been, you know, working on, where quick decision on that application, so that you know, it provides an incentive for people that by the time otherwise their technology used to get patented in India, it used to become obsolete outside, because not many people would patent that thing outside India. And therefore, we hope that all these steps are now going to create that ecosystem where India, Indian IP regime, also get suitable number of, you know, applications as they should be, because of the India's overall foundation in terms of technological institutions, in terms of the industrial base, and in terms of our research and development centers, whether in private or in public. So I need to, congratulate Parul University for undertaking this webinar, this 3-day webinar. When I see the topics, they have had covered almost all the topics which are there in IP and major in terms of information for the faculty and for the students. So this 3-day webinar should really, give that kind of information and create few innovators and startups in Parul University. That is what I wish for from this as output of this webinar. I should thank the management and the faculty and the program, vice chancellor in the university, and compliment them for this. Thank you very much for giving me opportunity to talk to faculty, students, and to everybody in this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your illuminating and very informative talk on the subject, which is very, very important. And I am also an alumnus of IIT Delhi. D.P. Agarwal was there in mechanical engineering, Professor Dr. D.P. Agarwal.
Yeah, he was my guide in my M.Tech project.
Oh, so he is my friend. We were in the same hostel, Shivalik. And then he rose to the chairman of Union Public Service Commission of India. That's a great honor. Thank you very much, sir, indeed. And we will definitely continue to work hard in the area of IPR in proliferating the message and disseminating the information and knowledge among masses. Thank you indeed, sir. Now we have a very important speaker from IPO, Sri Hardev Kararji, who is Joint Controller in Patent Office, Delhi at the moment. Sri Karar Saab has a MSc in chemistry and in IPR, and he is a very experienced person. He has experience as a patent examiner for 11 years and as controller for 18 years so far. So he is one of the pillars in the patent, Indian Patent Office, to proliferate and granting the patents and copyrights, etc. Presently, and he was former HO of NILPM and PIS Nagpur, and then JPO, USPTO, China. I'll request Karar Saab to talk about policies of Indian Patent Office about intellectual property rights, because they have been changing from time to time. Light was thrown by Sri O.P. Gupta ji, but Karar Saab is in the Patent Office for 18 years, maybe more, so he knows the whole nitty-gritty. So may I request him to throw light on these aspects. I want to mention here, this webinar has been possible because of rupees 25,000 rupees. We got the grant from Gush Coast and Narottam Sahu Saab is there from Gush Coast. He's always encouraging us, and we are grateful to Government of Gujarat and Gush Coast. And we got sanction of IPR cell in Parel University. That is a great thing, and done by Gush Coast to us, and I am grateful to Gush Coast. So, Karar Saab.
Thank you, sir. I'm audible.
Well, yes, yeah, you are audible, sir.
Okay. So, I begin with paying my respect to the chief guest, Sri O.P. Gupta ji, the Controller General of Patent Design Trademark, my boss, and then Patak Saab, who has taken a lot of pains for organizing this seminar awareness program, and all the dignitaries present in the is the webinar, and all the organizers who given so much efforts to this one. We all heard the address of learned CGPDTM, who throw the light on every corner of the IPR, patent policies, and everything. And I feel myself look like a candle before the sun. So, but still, I will take this opportunity to this seminar of IPR among engineering and technologists to appreciate the dynamic efforts of N. Pathakji to bring the webinar for the technologists and people linked to R&D when IPR knowledge is the need of the hour. I believe that the learned speakers would shower the late coming speakers will shower the knowledge of IPR to the attendees of the webinar. Patent Office, I can assure you that we are standing with you for imparting any kind of help, technical and all kind of guidance everywhere to the technologists like you, so that we can crack together more than the target, the international standards. Learner CG is very dynamic and knowledgeable. The CG used to quickly enter into the problem so that he can crack the problem and bring out the best solution to the, and that is the result we are seeing, that we are at the best position nowadays. So you might have seen our IPO of 90s, where we did not have any building, no sitting arrangement, no computers, nothing. But after the government policies for the modernization of the patent offices, that we have reached to the, we are now having four good kind of buildings which are fully digital. And we are making all kind of work digitally, and no paper is being used, and paperless office we are having. Also, the IPO's output is very high and with an excellent quality work. So quality is also maintained, which is compared with the international kind of examination and output. And thereby the India is capable of standing with the stars of the IPRs in the world. Then we have joined in 1998 the PCT, Patent Cooperation Treaty, and all kind of IPRs have joined some kind of treaties, and we have joined the PCT, Patent Cooperation Treaty, which have made the getting of the patent very easy. Because in this system, which we joined in 1998, only single application is filed, and it has effect in worldwide, all countries, 98 countries, and the output, examination output is shown to the applicant, and accordingly he can decide the getting of the patent in a particular country. Then, so we can save money, we can get a good patent. So we are having this kind of applications. About 80% applications are decimal phase application coming via PCT. The question was asked from me that whether there is the patent obtained is the global patent. So the answer is it is not a global patent. There's no word like global patent. The patent filed through PCT is the patent which will have to be filed in the national phase for getting a patent according to their own law, because it is a territorial right. So we are at the very good position, and time taken for examination and getting the patent was very high some days ago, but now we have gone through the backlog clearance projects and fast examinations. By this, we are now, as CG Sahab said, we have reached to the position that there is almost nil backlog, and we can grant you the patent as early as possible. So therefore, you must have the belief on us, and you can have the all kind of assistance from us, technical assistance for this patent system. So therefore, So I can close my words with this, and in case of any query, you can mail my address to me so that I can help you. Thank you.
Your assurance for helping us in all the way
yes.
to proliferate IPR. Thank you indeed. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Now we have our guest of honor, Dr. Narottam Sahuji, who is advisor GUSCOS, Government of Gujarat. Dr. Narottam Sahu is a scientist by profession and science educator by training, who has taken science to the common people. He has been recognized for his to public engagements and for igniting a sense of wonder among people about the world by unveiling the interplay between science, engineering, and the society. Dr. Sahu is at present serving as advisor and member secretary of Gujarat Council of Science and Technology, which is popularly known as GUSCOS, Government of Gujarat. He was also the senior scientist at Gujarat Science City, Ahmedabad, which, with which he has been associated since 2001. At GUSCOS, he is mandated with giving a new dimension to the promotion and popularization of science and technology in Gujarat. Before working in Gujarat, he was a postdoc fellow at Homi Bhabha Center for Science Education at Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Mumbai, for 2 years. During this period, he advised some interesting science education and communication modules for dissemination of science and technology among children and general public. Dr. Sahu completed his doctorate work in chemical sciences at the Regional Research Laboratory under CSIR in Bhubaneswar, and was confirmed with PhD degree by Utkal University in 1919. For his pioneering research work in lignin chemistry, Dr. Sahu was bestowed with the Institutional Prize Gold Medal of the Institution of Engineers India in 1998. His contribution to the field of natural science brought him the Young Scientist Award given by DST Government of Odisha in 2000. Dr. Sahu's innovative efforts towards science communication, motivational research, innovation management, governance, and policy development have made significant impact, leading to growth and development of science and technology ecosystem in the state of Gujarat. I am personally grateful to Dr. Sahu for granting us supercomputer very recently to proliferate climate change science in artificial intelligence, then big data management, then cloud computing, etc., which will prove to be a milestone in proliferating advanced engineering and technology education through Parul University. So, Dr. Sahu, may I request you to talk about policies about IPRs and science and technology and relevance to research and innovations in the state of Gujarat. Dr. Narottam Sahu, please.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible, sir? Good afternoon, sir. Respected chief guest of our today's program, Sri O.P. Gupta, sir. Chief Controller General of Patent Designs and Trademarks, Intellectual Property Office, India, Government of India, Mumbai office. Respected President of Parul University, Dr. Devanshu Patel, sir. Respected and Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir. Sri M. Dr. M. N. Patel, sir. Respected guest of honor, Sri Hardev Karad, sir. The main coordinator and the eminent faculty and distinguished scientist, Professor A. N. Pathak, sir. Professor M. H. Pulekar, sir. Dr. M. R. Yadav, sir, director of CRD Parul University. All the invited speakers, all the faculties, head of the departments, and dear students. It's a great pleasure to be here in this very important program organized by Parul University for the promotion of research development and creating this intellectually property right IP culture in the university and among young minds. I'm very happy, and on behalf of Gujarat Council on Science and Technology, Gujarat Coast, Department of Science and Technology, Government of Gujarat, I welcome the chief guest and all the distinguished guests in this program, all the faculties for this 3 days program. And I would like to also congratulate Dr. Pathak sir and Honorable Vice Chancellor sir for organizing this program in this pandemic situation and giving a platform and a seed of thinking and a seed of engaging all these young faculties and young students in the development of science, technology, and the innovations in the university curriculum. As you know, that intellectual property is the fuel for creativity. It is the right reward for creativity and for human endeavor, which fuels progress for humankind. As a well known and beyond any doubts, IP protection in every aspect is an important determinant for economic growth. For this thing, I think our chief guest, Sri O.P. Gupta sahab, has given a very comprehensive picture of IP ecosystem, its genesis, the present processes, the current, the programs and plans of Government of India and other institutions for promotion of IP cultures and helping our innovators or researchers in this field. So he has discussed about the national IPR policy in 2016 and the subsequent action plans with the Association of CIPAM, Association with collaborations with WIPO, and the technology innovation system, TIS, in these systems for IP protection, IP management, IP creations, and lots of things. In Gujarat, we have this Gujarat Coast under the umbrella of Department of Science and Technology. And we have also, the state has also adopted a very unique science technology innovation policy, which has given a lot of scope for IP creation, IP development, IP management among the university, the faculties, and the students, and the state governments. So as many of the faculties are aware about the fact that Gujarat Coast is also supporting the research and development. And recently, under the our national, the state STI policy, we have implementing two schemes. One is the research support for a hardcore researcher in university faculties and development departments. And we are also having a scheme for awarding the new technology deployment, which can be able to sort out our problems at large, supported by city-centric peoples, community members, so that we can get the technology and we don't wait for the research to be happened and we don't know whether it would be a positive outcome or a negative, and we have to lap the time as well as the money also. So one part is there, is open for all innovators, all faculties, all the researchers to be engaged and to be worked in a very state-specific problem in the current or in the cutting edge of science and technology. The other part is also that adopting the technology development, which has been developed anywhere either in India or abroad, and we have to implement for our own benefit. And we don't want to reinvent the wheel again, because the technology has already been developed somewhere else. So with these two major schemes, we also promoting the IP culture in the state. We have at Gujarat Coast, we have a very full-fledged IPR cell and I think one of our faculty is also being invited to deliver a session in this program, Dr. Satya Sridevi. And we have three scientists. They are very dedicated to their job. And every day we are having some sort of innovators, both from academic curriculum as well as the grassroots innovators, to whom our team members are giving support and guidelines and giving a hand-holding capacity, support for writing their understanding their problems and writing their patent drafts and submitting these things to the patent office. So our team is helping both in patent, in copyright protection, design, trademark registrations, and all the supports related to IP culture. In fact, the team has gone beyond the our scope. Now we are having this activities, awareness, and understanding, and real hardcore classroom activities in the schools, just in the secondary and higher secondary schools, just in the concept of you catch them young. So once the students, high school or higher secondary schools, they have all aware about this IP, the definition, the scope, the benefits. So they can be a real motivator in their graduation under post graduation and research studies. And I am very happy to share our success story here also. So Gujarat is the first state. We have whatever the program competitions we are having for the school students, including the National Children's Science Congress, where we are supposed to send 26 child scientists to the national level every year to participate in the National Children's Science Congress in the last week of December. So last year, out of 26 child scientists who represent the state in the Gujarat, in their very small project. So the Kutch Coast IPCL has registered some 4 to 5 patents. So that is in the active consideration of the patent office. In addition to that, our team is also giving some design certificate to the high school students also. So last year, few school students, they got the design certificates also from this thing. So this gives a lots of pleasure that at this stage, so they are holding of this IP certificate, which as our professor, sir, Chief Guest has mentioned that whenever he was doing his M.Tech in IIT Delhi, he was concerned or this thing discussed about this IPR things. Now the stage has come down to our high school students. They are not only discussing, they are holding some sort of IP certificate in terms of patent or a design or a copyright or something like that thing. If this our process, our approach, our motivation will be going in this way, no doubt, whatever, wherever we are at the race of this IP journey, definitely another 4 to 5 years, we have to compete with other the stakeholders and to be the forefront runner in this journey. So with these words, I congratulate the Parul University. I thank Professor Pathak sir for his kind concern and kind meticulous planning for this program. I have gone through the 3 days program. It was very meticulously designed. Very eminent experts, the domain experts, they have been invited. They have to talk to the students, the researchers, and the faculties. And there is no doubt that the students will get immense benefit in terms of a discussion, in terms of new ideas, new sharing of these experiences by the eminent experts. And it will be groom the IP culture and the IP mission of the Parul University. I congratulate the management, the Vice Chancellor, sir, and I hope that we'll be expecting this Parul University as an IP hub among all other state universities in this Gujarat. So thank you very much, and I wish this program a grand success. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Shaw sir, indeed, for your support, financial support.
Just one minute, Pathak sir. Uh-huh. Because we are well supported by Dr. Narottam Shahu, but he was never coming to the Parul University. But the credit goes to Corona that on this presentation, he has joined our both the program. So very much,
sir. We are with you, sir. We are with you, sir.
Remain continue with that, and also yes, that in future also by we have no problem. By VC, we can join.
So, no, sir. I will definitely come to you, sir. Thank you very much.
I heard you fully. Thank you.
Thanks.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Narottam Shahu sir. I really thank you from core of my heart for extending 25,000 rupees financial support for this webinar, without which it may not have been possible, but it is for a good cause. And I am sure South Sahab is always supporting us silently for the good cause, because our projects are good and merit. I am confident, not overconfident for it. We have submitted 23 projects in under scheme of COVID-19, only on mask and PPE, and we hope that our projects are found on merit, and we have worked very hard. We have burnt midnight oil in preparing the projects, and we expect some positive response in that. With those words, I thank you once again, and I thank Gujarat government and Gush Coast and GSBTM also for proliferating the message of IPR in the state of Gujarat. I wish to inform Narottam Sahu Sahab that 121 faculty members from over the state of Gujarat have registered, and two have registered from Rajasthan state, two have registered from Kanpur, from UP state, and one has registered from Patiala, from Punjab state. So although the program was for Gujarat state, but due to publicity, people afford that we should also be allowed to learn about IPR and all that. And then I extended, okay, that you can also join, why not? It is online and it is for the benefit of one and all. Thank you indeed.
Thanks.
Now I have a very dear colleague, Professor Dr. M.R. Yadav, who is a director in Center of Research and Development in Parul University. Dr. Yadav had a very long inning at Maharaja Sayaji Rao University in Baroda itself, and he was professor and head of pharmacy department. He was dean of the faculty, and he had his education in Banaras Hindu University. He is B.Pharm, M.Pharm, and PhD in pharmacy and pharmaceutical technology. He had association at Punjab, in Chandigarh, in Delhi University also. So he has a long experience. And Dr. Yadav, to his credit, has 5 patents already granted. So he knows the whole nitty-gritty, how to write the patent document, how to write the claims. And that's why he is there in Parul University now, and mainly helping us in patents and all IPRs. And mainly in research and development, he is helping us in the area of pharmacy and Ayurveda, because we have very big department of Ayurveda as well as the hospital also. So Dr. Yadav is a very learned man and dear colleague of mine. And he will be talking on relevance, patents and relevance to innovations and commercialization of technologies. So Dr. Yadav, please, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Dr. Parker. My senior colleague are giving a very nice introduction, giving a chance to share the information, whatever I know about patents and their relevance. As shown in the title, I would be talking Let me share the screen.
The screen
को on कर रहे हैं. He has to share the screen. Sir, अपने end पे screen को share करेंगे वहाँ.
इसको बंद कर दो. हाँ
Just wait for some time, there is some problem in screen sharing.
Hello, good morning, Patak sir.
Good morning.
As per the program, inaugural function, vote of thanks, till the time is there, can I propose? Then the lecture.
Okay, we can do that. In the meantime, he will set up his laptop. Yeah. Okay. So I request my dear very colleague, Professor Dr. M. S. Chulekar, who is a senior professor and joint director in our research and development setup. Professor Chulekar was senior professor in Gujarat Central University. As all of us know, senior professor is only 1% of the total faculty strength. And 10% of the professors working in a university. So Professor Chulekar is a very, very senior person, and he has been acting vice chancellor in Gujarat Central University. So I request him to give a vote of thanks for the inaugural session. And it will be followed by the talk by Professor Dr. Yadav. There is some problem in laptop. In the meantime, we can go ahead with vote of thanks to all dignitaries and invited lecturers.
Good morning to all. Dr. Devansu Patel, the president of Parul University, Dr. Vithika Madan Patel, the chairman of the Center of Research for Development, Dr. M.N. Patel, Vice Chancellor of Parul University, and today we have the chief guest, O.P. Guptaji, who is the Chief Controller General of Patent. Then we have the keynote we have heard, Hardev Karar, Dr. Navratan Sahu, the GUJCOS Director Advisor, Dr. Pathak, Dr. Yadav, Professor Yadav, other deans, director, faculty members, and participants. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks. So it is a vote of thanks for the inaugural function. Dr. Devansu Patel, the president of Parul University, a dynamic leader, under whose leadership the Parul University stand topmost 50 in the private state university. It's a really a great that Parul University have the all branches, the medical, technology, engineering, science, management, all. So, sir, you talk about the importance of the research, innovation, IPR, patent, and under your leadership, this university is doing very well. So we are grateful to you, sir, for having come and address to the dignitaries and the participants. Thanks. Dr. Gitika Madan Patel, the madam is very dynamic. Under her leadership, this Center of Research for Development has been developed. And we are doing a lot of activities in terms of seminar, workshop, the projects, then the filing of patent, IPR, etc., and leading towards a very good. And without research, there cannot be a good teaching and learning. And that is what the new education policy 2020 emphasizes. And Parul University is taking a lead in that direction. So we are very thankful to the madam, who is very active. In spite of her busy schedule, she involves in all activities and giving a good guidance and directing. Thank you, madam. Dr. M.N. Patel, the provost of Parul University, sir, was a vice chancellor of Gujarat University. Lot of achievement, progress has been done in Gujarat University. Then, sir, appointed as a vice chancellor of the Parul University. Parul University, under the vice chancellor leadership of Dr. M.N. Patel, the CR4D, the research and development is also progressing very well. Environmental audit, Sir is a member of the Gujarat Pollution Control Board, and environmental audit recognition is a great achievement to the Parul University. So, an environmental audit schedule 1, the audit is going on, doing very well, and the next schedule 2 audit will be there. So, we are developing a model laboratory, environmental audit laboratory and R&D laboratory under the dynamic leadership of the management. So, sir, your vice chancellor, your experience as an eminent academician is very much grateful and beneficial to the academician, all learned faculty and the young faculty. Thank you very much, sir. We have the chief guest, O.P. Gupta and Professor Patak, a dynamic person, as a director of the CR4D. He has brought O.P. Gupta. Sir, I am also from Maharashtra, but I have worked in studying Delhi and abroad other things. And now, since last 9 years, I am in Gujarat. So, you have worked in different capacities in Maharashtra. So, and you have focused on the IPR. Today, you know, biotechnology required long-term research and money. And that is why our right, which we have achieved in our research, has to be protected. So, IPR is very important. Then this IPR, we have the copyright, the trademark, the trade secret, the patent. The patent of Parul University have filed number of patent. Few patent are under the process of granting. So the IPR patent, you have emphasized on that one. So our today program is awareness of IPR, including property right. So many of us that younger faculty have understood about the IPR. Thank you very much, sir. Your address, and you are also in message on industry academic research, interaction of the industry academy, that is very important. But what we are doing, that should be beneficial to the society. So thank you. We are grateful to you on behalf of the Parul University. Then we have the keynote address, Hardar Karar Sahab. We have given the keynote address and emphasize on the IPR, patent, etc. Sir, chief guest, O.P. Gupta Sahab, chief controller, joint controller of Delhi. Their presence shows that one, it motivates us that yes, we are coming forward for doing the innovative research, innovation and research, protecting our IPR and filing the patent. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Professor Patak, Navratan Sahab, Dr. Navratan Sahab, see that this month itself, we have conducted one international program on climate change and sustainable development. That was funded by the Good Cause and under the leadership of Dr. Navratan Sahu. I can say he is a good, I can use the word, he is a good friend of mine and good colleague, academician. We have worked when I was a dean and director of Central University of Gujarat. And Good Cause, my 3 patent are in pipeline, and it is the sale under the Dr. Navratan Sahu leadership doing very well. And we have the 5 patent, and one is I'm going to deliver a talk on fly ash as a resource material that is a published, and patent is going to be granted. Only one last hearing is there, and it is all helped through the Dr. Navratan Sahu and his leadership. Good cause, the science and technology department, really I admire. Doing very well, this month itself we had a climate change and sustainable development international program. Your address, sir, and again your presence. So within this month itself, again you have through the Good Cause we have received the supercomputer. So all this, you know, our university is boosting because of our merit. That is what you are acknowledging. Thank you. For your presence, for your addressing, for your cooperation, seminar, conference, etc. We'll do very well, sir. Your money will be utilized very well, not beneficial to the academic and society. We have the Dr. Mata, my senior colleague. He told me I respect the knowledgeable person. So Dr. Patak has, you know, what is the patent, IPR, importance, very thing, and emphasizing on the important thing. And conducting the program, motivating the colleague, and so many things, good things within a year in terms of the research, innovation, the patent filing, the publication. So, Professor Patak sir, thanks to the all speaker, Professor Yadav, my colleagues, Parul University are grateful and thankful to the all dignitaries and the dean, faculty of the Parul University, other university. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Phulekar, indeed, for elaborate. Thank you to all dignitaries and all participants. Now, may I request my dear colleague, Professor Dr. M. R. Yadav, to go ahead with his talk.
There is some problem in screen sharing. So, I have sent the present PPT by mail. So, that can be uploaded.
PPT भेजा है उन्होंने ये किसके मेल पर भेजा
विजय पांडे है सेंट आई थिंक टू
गुड आफ्टरनून यादव सर सर आप एक बार वापस से ट्राई कीजिए सेनेगल
हैं
आप शेयर करने के लिए ट्राई कीजिए
तुम्हारे पास पीपीटी आया क्या
Is it being shared or not now?
Sir, are you getting that option of share screen?
I have put that on, but it is not coming. It is indicating screen sharing has failed to start.
Okay, sir, not an issue. You kindly forward the PPT to me. I'll just share it on your behalf over here.
Okay.
So my email ID is arvind.yadav@parulunivercity.ac.in.
Okay,
Hello, sir, has it come? Yes, sir. It is there and we have shared the PPT also, sir.
Okay.
It must be visible to you, sir.
Yeah. It is there.
Yes, sir.
So, very sorry to say that there was some problem in screen sharing, but now it is visible. As the title itself indicates, patents and their relevance to innovations in commercialization of technology, I would like to share some of my views and information with you. Next slide, please. You have to operate, Dr. Arvind, you have to operate now. So when we talk about patents, it is part of intellectual property. Now, what do we mean by intellectual property? Intellectual property is a part of intangible property. See, property broadly can be defined in two ways, tangible and intangible. Tangible is, you know, whatever movable or immovable property you have, that comes under tangible property. While intangible property is that property which you create through the capabilities of your intellectual. Now, under that we have a number of properties. I would like to concentrate more on patents. And when we talk about intellectual property, there are certain issues, broadly three issues. One is creation of the intellectual property. Second is, when you have created the intellectual property, how to safeguard, safeguarding of the intellectual property. And third is commercialization of the intellectual property. Next slide, please. So when we talk about creation of intellectual property in context of our country, see, when you compare it with a country like US, more than 50% of the knowledge creation is by institutes of higher education or learning. Now, when we compare our country, our conditions, we see that we have a poor track record as well as the creation of the intellectual property. And that there could be so many reasons behind that. But I personally feel that there are mainly two main reasons. One is, we have a system in education institution where we give more importance to public issues. And because majority of the researchers who are working in the Indian universities and institutions, they go for publication because they get credit for publications. Although credit is there for patent also, but you know, patent has certain other type of problems, like it takes very long time in getting the patent. Then there is a poor awareness about getting or writing the patent. And the second point is poor documentation. See, we people, unfortunately, are not that well trained in documentation. And here we face, suppose there is a controversy in writing of the filing of a patent, then we cannot prove that we are the first to discover a particular technique. So that proof of priority we lose. And these are some of the reasons, although the conditions in Western countries and India, they are quite different. And we unfortunately don't have too much emphasis on research. Unless we do research, unless we create the knowledge and the technologies, there's no question of going for safeguarding of the intellectual property. So that thing we have to change. Next slide, please. As I said, there are different varieties, different types of intellectual property. Broadly, I have divided into three categories. One is the copyrights, that is creations such as literature, art, music, sound recording, films, etc. And second, on which we will be concentrating, is the industrial property rights, which includes patents, industrial design, and trademarks. And the third is geographical indications, which somebody else will be talking about. And geographical indication, as you know, is mainly something which is restricted to a particular area. Say like the product he was talking about, basmati rice. It has already been procured under intellectual property by government of India. And similarly, there are so many other indications like Kashmiri Pashmina shawl, then Bikaneri bhajia, and all that. So that type of thing. So under these three categories, we will be concentrating on patents. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So, coming to the patent, what is a patent? So, we have to understand that it is a right or authority given to the owner to exclude others from exploiting the patented invention. That means when you have created something with your intellect power, you
Dr. Amar Yadav sir, you are not audible to us. Hello, Dr. Amar Yadav sir. Dear participants, we are extremely sorry. Due to technical problem, our expert is disconnected. Just give us a few minutes. He'll be connected soon.
헬로 헬로 아 so dear participants, there is some technical error with respect to the laptop of our expert Professor M.R. Yadav. But he will join us very recently. In the meantime, as a fill in the gap, I want to inform you that patent is very, very important, and you must give much more emphasis on patents. Publications are important for advancement in career, but patent is also equally important, because in government ratings of NIRF, or Atal ranking, or state ranking, there is enough emphasis on patents, particularly in MUP area, that is Atal ranking, which is being decided by MHRD, Government of India, directly. Patents and copyrights have been given a special place for university, and universities should be vigilant on this, and the faculty members who are taking more patents, filing or getting granted, and taking copyrights, on which I will talk tomorrow morning, first lecture, from 10 to 11 a.m., I'll tell you, you see, the copyright in India is separate compared to USA, where you see on softwares, in USA you get patent, but in India you will get only copyright, besides books and your publications, etc. So, one other aspect, I am surprised that you see NIRF rating form, there is a column, they say, they ask universities how many global patents are there, or how many world patents are there. There is nothing like global patent and world patent, and therefore NIAC office also needs to be educated that there is nothing like that. That column point mentioned in NAC form is full of fault, and I have written a letter to the Minister MHRD, Ramesh Pokharial ji, about this, because the evaluators must know everything in detail. The examiner should have more knowledge than the examinee, and NAC accreditation body must know it well, that what is patent and how it is granted. There is nothing like world patent or global patent, which was told by Hardev Karar also, because I tried to demystify my doubt, although I was sure, and he concurred that there is nothing like world patent or global patent. So all the faculty members who are attending, they are numbering 123 registrations, they must know all that there is nothing like world patent or global patent. However, through patent cooperation treaty route, you can file patent in the more than one countries. Patent is a geographical right, and its right is valid only in that country. For example, you have Indian patent. It is not valid in Pakistan, Lanka, or Bangladesh. If you want your product or process to be patented there, you have to file the separate patent. Same is true for USA and European Federation, European Union, or other countries. So if you want patent, let's say in 50 countries, you have to file in all 50 countries through patent cooperation treaty route. So it's like that. Abhi Vijay ka bhi chalu nahi hoga. The other thing I want to tell you, that people talk about patent, take patent on this book or patent this logo and all that. They are not correct. Patent is granted only on innovations or inventions, and it must fulfill four basic principles. It should not be in public domain. It must have novelty. It must have inventive step, and the patented, whatever patent you are seeking for, it must be commercialized. It must have commercial value. So you have to see your invention or innovation that it fulfills the four things. And anything which has come in the public domain cannot be patented. I want to give you one example. Shri Opi Gupta ji threw some light on that. One important thing is, Sir J.C. Bose, Jagdish Chand Bose, had invented coherer. He was in hurry. He published information about coherer, but he did not take a patent. Much later, Marconi used that coherer in wireless telegraphy, and he took patent, and Marconi earned billions of dollars, while J.C. Bose could not earn even $1. So whenever you want to commercialize a thing, you have to be careful. It should not be in public domain. Thank you very much. Our dear colleague M.R. Yadav is back, and now his talk will proceed.
Hello, am I audible now? Can you hear me? Hello? Hello? Hello, am I audible? Hello? Hello? I'm not getting it.
Sir, you are audible to us. You may start, please.
Okay. Now, yes. So, should I start from the very beginning?
Yeah. Yes, sir, you may.
Okay. So, the title is already known, and I have already said something. I'll be deliberating on patents and their relevance to innovations and commercialization of the technology. Next slide, please. So, as I said earlier, intellectual property is an intangible property, unlike a tangible property like your land, maybe your house or something. This is a property which you have to create using the capability of your intelligence. And when we talk about intellectual property, there are different issues like creation of the intellectual property. Then once you create the intellectual property, maybe in the form of patent or design or anything, then second question comes, safeguarding of the intellectual property. And third point which comes is the commercialization. Now, creation of intellectual property is very, very important, because unless you create, the remaining two points, they are of no value. if we compare our country with US, you know, in US more than 50% of the knowledge creation is by institutes of higher learning. Here in India, unfortunately, it's a very poor track record as far as the creation of the technologies and the knowledge is concerned. And there are different reasons behind that. One reason I find especially in our educational institution is the publication, because the teachers, they get credit for publications and they don't get that much credit for the patent because of number of reasons, like patent takes very long time. Then people are not very much aware about how to file a patent and how to get it and so on. And another very important point which is lacking in our researchers is the documentation part. Suppose you file a patent and somebody else also files, and then there is a question of priority. You have to give a proof of the priority. And unless you have a proper documentation, you cannot prove. Now, when we talk about intellectual property, I have divided the intellectual property in three categories. One is broad category of copyrights, which is creations such as literature, art, music, sound, recordings, films, etc. And second is the industrial property rights, which includes patents, industrial design, and trademarks. And third is geographical indications like Basmati rice or maybe Kashmiri Pashmina shawl or Bikaneri bhurji or something like that. And there are a number of them. Now, what is a patent? Patent is a right or authority which is given to the owner to exclude others from exploiting the patented invention, like what type of rights you have for making or for using or for selling the patented technology. So these are the exclusive right to make, use, manufacture, market, and invention. And a very, very important thing is that patent is territorial in nature. That means if you file a patent in India, its validity remains only in India. There is nothing like global patent or international patent or world patent. If you want to safeguard your patent in different countries, then individual applications have to be filed in those countries. So it's not that once you file a patent application in India, it is valid throughout the world. It's not like this. So it is territorial in nature. Then right is available for a limited period of time. That means once you get the patent, that patent is granted to you. That means the rights are being granted to you for a limited period of time. Like in India, that time period for patent is 20 years. That means you can exploit the patent for 20 years. And then after the lapse of this 20 years, then it is open, it is a public property. Anybody can make it, anybody can utilize it. It is like a property right, hence can be gifted, inherited, assigned, sold, or licensed. So that all the rules and regulations for patent, that is, which is an intangible property, the rules are just like any tangible property. Now, what can be patented? So this is a big question. Comes to the mind of researchers. Now, a patent may be obtained on anything under the sun that is made by man. That's important. But there are certain riders in that. What are these riders? Or what can be patented? There are certain conditions to be fulfilled. Like an invention. What is an invention we'll define? Which is novel. That means novelty has to be there. And that novelty could be in either of these two things or could be both. It is a novel product or it is a novel process, or it could be a novel product involving a novel process. Second is the inventiveness. And third is it must have industrial application. Unless you specify what is the industrial application, patent may not be granted to you. And then fourth is patentable subject matter. There are certain things which cannot be patented. Coming to an invention, how you define an invention? It means a product or process involving an inventive step and capable of industrial application. Patentability of an invention is an important criteria which involves all these three: novelty, non-obviousness, and usefulness. Unless some some invention has a use, it cannot be put to industrial application. How we define novelty? Anything, any invention, any technology which is not known or not published before filing an application. Of course, this is also very, very important that a grace period of 12 months can be given. Suppose by mistake or unknowingly you have published your invention and still you want to get the patent, then within 12 months it can be filed and it can be granted. Then patent search is essential for ascertaining novelty, because unless you ascertain that this is a new and novel, you know, anything which is existing in the public domain will lose the novelty. The invention need not be a major breakthrough. But this is important because some people think that anything which is very hi-fi or complex type of thing only can be patented. It's not like this. Simple inventions can also be patented. The second condition, inventiveness, which means non-obviousness. That means prior art should not point towards the inventor. And when we talk about non-obviousness, it is in context of the people who are trained in the prior art. It is not in context of general public. And complexity of or simplicity has no bearing on the grant of the patent. As I said earlier also, that it could be a simple invention. That doesn't mean that it cannot be patented. Simple things can also be. And the third thing is the usefulness, but it must have utility in the society. Otherwise, if it doesn't have any utility, it cannot be patented. Must have product utility, and that should be specified out. When you file an application, you have to specify what for this particular invention can be utilized. And if it is a process, then you have to specify how to practice this. Suppose I have invented a process for the synthesis of some particular drug. It is new and novel, but then you have to specify exactly how it can be practiced, how it can be utilized. Now, how can novelty be determined? Here, new invention means any invention or technology which has not been anticipated by publication in any document in the country or elsewhere in the world, for use or work in the country before data filing of the patent application. That means the subject matter has not fallen in public domain, or that it doesn't form part of the state of the art. Then only it will come under the invention, new invention. Now these are certain novel destroying elements, like if there is a prior art, people already know, maybe part of the society know how to make it, then that has destroyed the element of novelty. Or there is a prior claim or prior public use. The public is already in use of that particular technology. Then it has no novelty. Or prior public knowledge. Now all these things, they destroy the novelty aspect of the invention. What do we mean by prior art? There is a written description, or there is even oral description, that will also destroy the prior art. Or there is already a use of that particular technology, or in any other form, if it is known to the public or to the society, then that destroys the prior art, and then that type of invention cannot be made. Now, prior art is knowledge that is relevant to the invention. It includes previous patents and non-patent literature such as journal articles, publications, brochures, books, and catalog, internet publications. All these that will come under prior art. Then public readings and discussions. If suppose you have discovered a technology and you discuss in public about this technology, that will come under public discussion. Displays at exhibitions or shows, that will also destroy, that will come under prior art. Public use, public working within the country, then that will also kill the prior art. Prior art is any disclosure of the contents of a claim made before the priority date of the application for a patent. So prior art must not be there if there is an invention for which you want to file a patent. What do we mean by public use? Publicly available products, a device or article or part thereof, available in the market before filing date of the patent application, demonstration of the product will be published. It will come under public notice. Now, when is an invention not anticipated? Now, say if you have communicated your invention to government or to any person authorized by the government for the purpose of investigation, then that will not come under the anticipation. That means that type of thing, although you have disclosed, but you have disclosed to government or to government officials, then you know that will not kill your invention. Then public display, reading before a learned society, or publication in the transcription of such society, that will also not be anticipated. Field trials, that will also not be considered, because under these, all these conditions, the prior art will not be considered, because they will not come under prior art. So that type of invention can be patented. But here the condition is that the patent application has to be filed within 1 year. That means within 12 months you have to file the patent. How can inventive step be determined? Presence of a feature that makes the invention not obvious to a person. This is what I said, that it must be known obvious to a person skilled in the art. If suppose there is a technology which you have developed, and if that technology has been developed using the mechanical engineering basic principles, and that must be obvious, or it must be non-obvious to a mechanical engineer. That means he should not be able to make it without following your patent. So that is the meaning of non-obviousness. Now there are certain items which cannot be patented, although it may involve the novelty, it may involve the inventive step, it may involve non-obviousness, but still there are certain inventions which cannot be patented, and they have been listed under the rules and regulations of the patent laws. One is frivolous or against the established natural laws. Like one example is perpetual machines. This should be known to people in engineering. Say if I claim that I have discovered, I have invented a machine which runs on its own. How, like, you know, I have invented a car which will utilize no fuel, because it will use only the battery energy, and the battery will be charged by the movement of the wheel. So that type of machines are called perpetual machines. So this is against the basic natural laws. So this cannot be patented. Use of invention against public order or morality. That is, say if I claim that I have invented a drug which is a substitute of brown sugar, or I have discovered a process for brown sugar which is misused. So that is against the public order, against the morality of the public order. So again, this cannot be patented. Mere discovery of scientific principles. I have discovered certain thing which is a mathematical solution of something, or maybe a new law in physics, something like that, or maybe a new chemical reaction. Now these mere scientific principles, they cannot be patented. Then new usage of a new substance. Now this particular thing is very, very important, and I face lot of queries from especially pharmacy people. Like say they have a drug which is already known, it is existing in the public domain, it has a particular clinical use, but they find out that this particular drug can be utilized for something else, for some other drug. So can it be patented? No. New uses of any known substance in India cannot be patented. And mere discovery of new form of known substances which does not result in enhancement of known efficacy of substances. Like say, if you have a drug which is acidic in nature, you convert into a salt or ester or polymorphs or metabolites or any other isomer or mixture of isomers. Suppose it exists in geometric isomerism, and you say that the mixture can be patented. Or combination and derivatives, unless they differ significantly in efficacy. So suppose there is one particular optical isomer another optical isomer of the same drug and that causes synergism, then yes, it can be patented. So simple admixture without synergism is not patentable. But if you can scientifically prove that mixing two components will cause any process of medical, surgical, diagnostic or therapeutic use for human beings, say that I have invented a process or maybe a process of a way of putting different surgical instrument in particular order so that the surgery becomes very easy. So that type of thing aspect of patent is the term, and as I said, the term of an application. And this is something very, very important. What I have observed that in Indian system, it takes 4 to 5 years in getting a patent. So that means out of these 20 years, you are already losing those 4 or 5 years. So getting a patent at a faster rate is important. In the sense, if industry can be exploited, then the grant of the process of granting of patent has to be very fast so that you get more time for exploiting that particular patent. Now, what are the documents required for filing an application? Now, there are two ways in which you can file your application. One is provisional specification. Now, what happens? You have some invention, but you have not completed the complete investigation on that, and you want to have a priority date for that particular invention. So you can file a provisional application with a provisional specification, where you need not give complete specifications of the invention, but the complete specifications have to be provided within 12 months of date of filing of the provisional application. No patent granted on provisional specification. So complete specifications have to be provided within 12 months. But the best option is, if you are quite sure that nobody is going to copy or nobody is going to get a priority for the type of invention on which you are working, go for complete specifications. So this is in brief, I have discussed as far as the patent and related things are concerned. Details is not possible in short duration of time. It can be covered sometime else. Now comes the relevance of patenting. Why should we go for patenting? What are the reasons? Now there are different reasons why we should go for patenting. It encourages innovations, very important thing. It results in technological development. Now you should understand one thing. Although the protection is territorial in nature, as I said, if you have an invention and if you file the application in India, but the information is available through globe. That means in all the countries that information is available. That means whatever the development you have made in the invention, how you have developed that invention, because complete specifications are available. So anybody can work on that and can bring out a better innovation, can come out with a better invention. So the results in technological developments can be utilized. And that is the reason, you know, patent office wants that all patent applications should specify the specification in detail. That means you must not leave any minor point. So that if suppose somebody wants to make an invention out of that, they want to make it, they want to manufacture it, they can do it very easily. So that is one very important point, that filing a patent and getting a grant encourages innovations. But of course, it enhances the quality of human life. Once you get a technology, it enhances the quality of life. Because maybe the cost is very high in the beginning, but after the lapse of the patent period, it is going to come out very cheap. Second relevance, which is incentive to the researcher in terms of recognition and material rewards. So if suppose you have invented some technology, it is your technology. So not only that you get material rewards because you can get money out of it by selling it or by licensing it, but you also get credit for that invention which you have discovered. Then it avoids duplicating the R&D efforts. That is very, very important. It enables future researchers not to invent the wheel. That means if suppose this particular invention has not been patented, then this information is not available in the public domain. Then that means somebody else might be working on that type of invention again. So that is something like inventing a wheel. So the information disclosed in the patent is normally not available in research publication, but it is available in the patent offices. And about, this is very important, about 1/3 of the technological information is available in patents. So this is a huge knowledge which is existing in the form of patents. So if people don't take patents, then you are losing this 1/3 of the knowledge which goes missing. So that is very important. Patent is important not only for the author, but for whole of the society, and not for knowledge based and for public knowledge economy. Then we come to the commercialization of the patent. Now, it gives incentive for the innovation, provides incentive for technological innovations, which is a big factor in trade competitiveness. So there is a competitor for you for a particular product and you have a patent. So obviously you have an upper hand in the business. So technological development, manufacturing and marketing entails great cost, and the incentive for this is provided by IP protection. Suppose I have an invention, and if that invention is being copied or being duplicated by somebody else, then you know whatever exploitation I would have done for that particular invention, somebody else will do. That means the cost which I incurred on this particular invention, I will not be able to make it. So that's the reason you must go for patenting, and especially in the field of business, this is very important. Patenting is significantly and directly related to R&D expenditure. See, if there is an R&D company which has a large number of patents, then you know, and you are commercializing also, that means you are getting money out of the commercialization so that you can further invest into R&D. If suppose you have an R&D and the technology or the drugs which you are inventing or discovering, that goes into the public domain, then you will not get the money for further putting into the R&D. So that is another reason for patenting, that if you can go for commercialization, you can recover the cost and you can further go for more and more R&D in that particular field. Recoup the investment for the money and time spent in developing the technology. That is what I mean, that you can recoup the investment you have made in developing that particular technology. In absence of protection, no one will ever invest in the promise of an invention. See, if you are inventing something but you are not going for patenting, then who will invest in your company? Because in that case, they know that you are not going to recover back the cost. So from that angle also, you must go for patent so that you can recover the amount which you have invested in discovering that particular patent. It provides technological and market information, which can be invaluable to both researchers and the policy makers. See, nowadays, you know, whenever patent applications are filed in the patent offices, statistics can be performed. In fact, the companies have statisticians who go on analyzing the type of patent which are being filed or granted, in what particular field they are being granted. So that statistics is being used for market information, in which particular direction we have to move. So that particular decision the business houses normally take by that type of stats. Patents reveal which nations and companies are developing what new technologies, which allows assessment of international competition to make better business decisions. So this is what I said, that you know, after studying all those statistics, you know, better business decisions can be taken. And of course, patents generate interest in the investors, because if you have, your company has more number of patents, then the investor, they have more faith in your company, they will invest more, and the company obviously will grow. Then patent statistics reveal trends in that trade competition, in which particular field work is going on. So that knowledge is being gained from the patents. So it reveals trends in the technological activities of the foreign competitors. What type of work is going on, maybe in England or in Germany, they immediately come to know so that they can start work in that particular. Patents protect domestic market. Now this is a very, very important aspect of protecting the domestic market. Suppose I have a patent, I have filed my application in India and I have got the patent from Indian Patent Office and I am making it. Now some other party, maybe my business competitor, he may import the same thing maybe from some other country in which I have not filed a patent, because in that case it may be a cheaper one, but that is not allowed under the laws. If suppose I have patent in India for a particular product or technology, now that technology or product cannot be allowed to be imported without my permission. So that's how, you know, the domestic market is being protected by the patent regime. Patents help entry into foreign markets. So you may be having subsidiary in other company, so you can file a priority application, and after filing a priority application, then you know, you can ask your subsidiary company to start manufacturing it, so you can exploit the foreign market also by having a priority application for that. It provides international license fee income. Say if suppose you don't want to go into manufacturing in some other country, so what you can do, you can license your patented technology to some other company, so that royalties and fees for the use of rights and management fees, they are creating a revenue flow for licensing agreements. You can go for a licensing agreement. There are different type of licensing agreements. I'm not going to discuss all those. But through that licensing agreement, you can generate a lot of revenue, which will recoup your investment on the R&D which you have done. Gives a freedom of movement in a crowded field. Suppose there is a lot of competition in a particular technology, but you have obtained a patent. So obviously, you have definitely have a priority, and you can easily move in the field. That means you remain free of tension. And you need not bother about the competition from other companies. Generates prior art to protect company from patent infringements. If suppose you go for early patent of a technology, then you know the other companies are being indirectly inhibited not to go for R&D in that particular area, because then you have already protected your rights, and the companies, other companies cannot infringe your technology. It creates competitiveness for industries. Obviously, I have discussed that. Increases overall corporate value, because once you have higher number of patents, your corporate value definitely goes up. Increases private investment into R&D. If you want to fetch more of the private investment, and you are a company who is having large number of patents doing R&D in that particular area, it increases that investment. It has an impact on GDP and employment opportunities in the particular country. Very stark example is of China in comparison to India. China, let me tell you, has even surpassed USA as far as filing of the patent throughout the world is concerned. Then it is an important index for a country's growth. If you are having more number of patents being filed or being granted in your country. So that is an index how your country is growing. And let me tell you, it is a poor state of affairs as far as our country is concerned. It creates spin-off companies. That is important for an institution like Parul University. If we go for inventions, go for discoveries, and we safeguard our inventions by filing patents, spin-off companies can be floated. That is very important from our angle. Coming to almost the last part of my presentation, where do we stand as far as filing of application is concerned? This is the data I got from the literature for 5 years. See, when you compare India with other Asian countries and whole of the world, see what is the trend. Trend is, in fact, in 2013, we had more percentage share of filing of the patents. And it is going down as far as comparison with other Asian countries. Same is the trend here in whole of the world. When you compare the patent filed by the rest of the world in comparison to the patents applications filing by Indians, see, there is a downward trend. Although the number of applications are increasing, see here also in India it is increasing, but it is not a substantial increase. It's a very marginal increase. While in case of Asian countries and world, you see there is a sharp increase in the patents filed and granted. And when we talk about Indians, again, you know, there is a disparity. There is more number of patents filed by non-resident Indians in comparison to the resident Indians. When you see, when you compare it, India and Asia, you again see that, you know, resident Indians, they are remaining almost constant or maybe slight decrease, while non-resident Indians, although they are also constant, but the share is very large in comparison to the resident Indians. And same is the trend here in the world scene also, that resident Indians, they have very poor share, and the main share is being taken by the non-resident Indians. So this trend has to change. And this trend will only change when we go for more of innovations and we create more of awareness about patenting. And let me tell you that in Parul University, we now want Parul University to be a research-oriented university. And not only that, it has to become a research-oriented industry. We also help our researchers, maybe teachers, maybe students, to file patents. We give all logistics for filing patents. See, there are certain constraints as far as the students and teachers for filing patents are concerned. One very big constraint is, as I said, lack of awareness. Then they don't know, majority of them, they don't know how to file a patent, where to file a patent. And another very important factor which I in fact faced in my earlier appointment, lack of money. See, number of people, they don't like to file because they don't have sufficient money to file a patent application and to defend it. Now here in Parul University, we have assured all researchers that whatever money they spend on filing patent, it will be reimbursed by the Parul University. So we are taking enough steps so that the percentage of filing of patent that goes on increasing. So this is what I wanted to present in front of you people. This is a small information which I had to share with you. And I would like to answer a few questions if you have any. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Professor Yadav, for very illuminating talk on patent and its commercialization. People must understand that whatever they invent and whatever innovations or inventions are done, and if it is patentable, it must be patented. Because one must get the benefit out of his research, and that's what intellectual property means. Until unless you patent, you cannot generate any intellectual property. and many Indians, because we have not been in from the beginning moving on material benefits. Jagdish Chandra Bose invented coherer and he didn't patent it. He published in journal Nature and he became FRS, Fellow of Royal Society England, and he was very happy. But Marconi later on used that coherer in his wireless telegraphy, and Marconi patented it and made billions of dollars. So that is the difference. Even if you don't want money, you must patent it. Utna paisa mile daan kar do kisi educational sansthan. There are people like John Salk. He invented polio vaccine. He could have patented it. He patented, but he did not want any royalty from anybody. So that also can be done. If you are not interested in money, don't earn money, but must patent it and give it free. Patent does not say that you must charge money. Once it is patented, royalty taking on patent is your right, whether you take it or not. But you must patent. That is my message. Thank you very much, Professor Yadav. And dear colleagues, it was very enlightening.
I would like to say I'm sorry that I had to rush through my slides because of that.
You need not feel sorry. It is a technical system. Anything can happen. Power is not there. Then Zoom is not working. Anyway, what matters? The talk you gave, and that's very illuminating. Thank you indeed. Thanks. Are you be like Shali? We will do. We will have lunch. Announce. Kar de. So we will have a breakfast lunch now.
Thank you very much for being
Saturday ko.
So for lunch break and will return at 2:30 PM. Thank you.
Thank you. We will meet again at 2:30 PM for lecture by Dr. Satya Sridevi after lunch. And till I request all participants to enjoy their lunch.